The Sikkarim Fort is located at a distance of 18 kilometers from Panjim. The fort stands overlooking the Sikkarim beach and bisects the shoreline into two. This fort was constructed in the year 1612. There is an extension of the larger upper fort. The lower fort consists of a bastion and a section of fortified wall on both sides. The main intention of building the fort was to guard Goa against the Dutch and the Marathas. This is the Aguada Fort. Although parts of it have fallen to the ravages of time, much of it's intact and its remains have been best preserved. During its use, ships would stop at the lower fort for supplies and water. Aguada Fort is housed by a four-story Portuguese lighthouse erected in 1864, which is the oldest kind in Asia. This lighthouse is no longer in use, having been replaced by a new one constructed recently. A huge tank with underground chambers is located at the center of the fort. The Viceroy's Ark, erected in 1599 by Viceroy Francisco da Gama, was once the main street for entering Old Goa. It was built as a memorial to the achievements of Vasco da Gama, the famous explorer. Francisco da Gama was the great-grandson of Vasco da Gama and was the governor of Goa from 1597 to 1600. In 1954, the Ark was reconstructed with Vasco da Gama's statue on the riverside and the statue of Saint Catherine on the other side. It is also known to have been one of the gates of the Adil Shah Palace and is made of laterite. This 46 meters high colossal four-story tower was meant to serve as a belfry and form part of the facade of the Church of St. Augustine, which was facing west. There were 8 richly adorned chapels and 4 altars and a convent with numerous cells and artistic columns attached to the church. The tower and the church were built in 1602 AD by the Augustinian friars who arrived in Goa in 1587 AD. The building fell into neglect, resulting in the collapse of the vault in 1842. The facade and half of the tower fell in 1931 and some more parts of it collapsed in 1938. This fort was one of the first bastions of the Portuguese rulers against enemy invasion. The fort has been skillfully repaired in recent years and partly restored to its former glory. It is clearly visible with its distinctive reddish stone walls all the way from Panjim, which lies across the Mandovi River from it. It was constructed of the readily available and extremely durable laterite rock. The walls are high and formidable due to their steep slopes. There are cylindrical turrets or watchtowers, typical of Portuguese fort architecture, at strategic points along the walls. The fort also has within its walls a freshwater spring which kept the troops well supplied with this essential resource. An arsenal of 33 cannons of various sizes, the fort was well equipped to deal with invaders making their way up to the Mandovi, to the then capital of Goa. However, it was not sufficient to stop the insurgence of Dutch ships and was replaced by the Fort Aguada as the main safeguard of the Portuguese colony. The fort could accommodate a fully armed garrison and has a wealth of underground rooms and passages. The fort now serves as a cultural center and is a prominent tourist attraction along with the nearby Reis Magos Church.